Well, welcome back to the Moodle orientation tour. In this section, let's take an overview of Moodle and see how it's set up. I'm going to be covering a lot of information very quickly, but don't worry, we will come back and go into greater detail on each of those in the programs that follow. For now, let's pretend you're entering a class for the very first time. So let's open the page, and you're going to see the standard blank template used for most courses here at HSU. And really, it's fairly simple. We have three columns. In the left, we have the course menu, and we see control panel, gradebook, and a number of different items. In the center, it's set up in a topic outline format. We have the news forum at the top left. This is where our content will go, our syllabus, our assignments, our quizzes, and any illustrations we wish to use. And here in the right-hand column, as we look, we see latest news that tells us about activity, such as posting a syllabus, a quiz, or a handout, messages from other students or other faculty members within the class, and administration, which gives you an awful lot of control of things you can do, such as turn editing on and off, setting, and working in the gradebook. Let's come to the top of the right-hand column, and there's the turn editing on button again. Both of them work identical. And right next to it, it says switch role. Well, if you use the drop-down, you'll see that you can view this course as a student or as an instructor's assistant might, and this is very useful for you when you are ready to have the students see the class. You'll see what they're going to see, so you don't have any embarrassing omissions. Right above that, it says you're logged in as you, and there's a very important button, the logout button. Do remember to always log out of Moodle correctly. For now, we're going to turn editing on, and to do that, I'm just going to select the turn editing on button right under my name. And when I do that, look how the screen changes. In the center column, after news forum, a number of interesting icons appear. Those icons are used for moving content from one block to another. For example, if I chose to put the news forum under item number one, I could click. I could select the blank spot in item number one, and there's the news forum. I can move it indented. I can use a little hand holding a pencil to update my content. I can use the X to delete it, the I to hide it, and that little weeble looking thing is going to tell you if you're in a group or not. You'll learn more about that when we deal with forum. On the right-hand side of the center column, we see both adding a resource and adding an activity. A resource is something the students can use. By selecting the drop-down button, we'll see things like books, labels, or the most commonly used, link to a file or website. With this application, you can actually choose to link to a website, Amazon, something course-related, YouTube, or you can link to a specific file, and this is where your syllabus and things will be uploaded. You can also add an activity. Those are things students should do, and as we select the drop-down, we have a number of different types of assignments, such as online text and uploading of a single file. You can deal with attendance issues, chat, and a very popular feature, the forum. Again, these will all be covered in additional presentations. And when we turned editing on, let's look at the bottom of the right-hand column. Under administration, something called blocks has appeared. This allows you to customize your Moodle page and reduce the amount of time you spend finding items. For example, I'm going to add activities. And when I do, it appears right above the blocks choice. I'm then going to add people. I'm going to scroll down a bit, and I'm going to once again add Quick Mail. Now, activities, people, and Quick Mail can be moved anywhere on the page. So, let's move the activities over to the left-hand column. We can use our four-way arrow to drag it there. I'm also going to take people and move it on over to the left-hand column. Now, you do have the ability to move things within a column. I like people at the top of a column. It's a personal choice, and you'll, of course, have your own. So let's drag people to the top of the left-hand column on top of the course menu. And I like to keep administrative things on one side and informational on the other, so I'm going to move Quick Mail over here to the left as well. That's all the time for now. Next time, join us. We're going to put these tools to work. As always, please come to the top of the screen. Remember to turn editing off and to log out. We'll see you soon. Thanks for joining us.